Dear students, in this video lecture we are going to see the another equalizer algorithm, least mean square algorithm, otherwise it is known as LMS algorithm. The criterion of this LMS algorithm is to minimize the mean square error between the desired and actual equalizer output. The prediction error is defined as EK is equal to DK minus DK cap, where DK is the desired output and DK cap is the output of the equalizer. Already we know the DK is approximately equal to the input, so DK is equal to XK. So EK is rewritten as XK minus DK cap, where this DK cap is the output of the equalizer, which is the product of the input vector and the weight vector. So DK cap is equal to YK transpose into WK, also which is equal to WK transpose into YK. So by replacing the above expression in place of DK cap, the prediction error is now rewritten as EK is equal to XK minus YK transpose into WK, also is equal to XK minus WK transpose YK. The mean square error is calculated by taking the expectation of EK square. So EK is the error, the square is the EK square, and the mean square error is the expectation of EK square. The prediction error depends on the tap gain vector. Here we define the cost function J of WN, which is nothing but the mean square error and is expressed as a function of tap gain vector WN. In order to find the expression of this J of WN, let us consider the expression which we have derived in the topic of adaptive equalizer. The mean square error was already derived as expectation of XK square plus WK transpose expectation of YK YK transpose into WK minus 2 into expectation of XK YK transpose into WK. So in this slide, the first equation, in the second term, the expectation of YK YK transpose is nothing but auto correlation matrix, so which is replaced by RNN. In the third term of the first equation, expectation of XK YK transpose is the cross correlation vector, which is replaced by PN transpose. So the mean square error is now written as expectation of XK square plus WN transpose. For our convenience, the WK is replaced by WN. So WN transpose into RNN into WN minus 2 PN transpose into WN. The mean square error is here defined as the cost function denoted as J of WN. So the same second equation is written for the cost function. Then in the third equation, in the second term, the WN transpose is multiplied with the WN, then it becomes WN square. So now the cost function is rewritten as expectation of XK square plus RNN into WN square minus 2 PN transpose into WN. Here our criterion is to minimize the mean square error. That means we are going to find the minimal function or minimal value of the cost function J of WN. Already we know that to find the minimal value, we have to first take the first order derivative and equate the first order derivative as 0. So now let us take the derivative of the fourth equation, cost function with respect to WN. So if we derive the cost function, then the first term in the fourth equation, which will become 0 because it does not contain any WN term. then in the second term, if we take the derivative with respect to Wn, it will become 2Rnn into Wn. Then the third term will become minus 2Pn transpose. So this is written as the first order derivative of the cost function dou by dou omega n of j omega n is equal to minus 2Pn plus 2Rn into Wn, which is equal to 0. So from this the 2 gets cancelled. So if you bring this minus Pn to the right hand side, then Rnn Wn will be equal to Pn. This equation is known as the normal equation. Here the error is minimized and the error is orthogonal to the desired signal. Then the minimum mean square output of the equalizer is expressed by g of Wn is equal to expectation of xk square minus Pn transpose into Wn cap. This is obtained by substituting this Rn Wn as Pn in the fourth equation of this slide. So in this fourth equation, this in place of that is in the second term, in place of Rn Wn, if we substitute Pn transpose, then it is written as like in fifth equation, the expectation xk square plus Rn Wn is replaced by Pn transpose. So Pn transpose into Wn minus 2Pn transpose into Wn. Now let us combine the second and third term, which will become as minus Pn transpose Wn. So totally this the minimum mean square output expression is expectation of xk square minus Pn transpose into Wn. That is given in this slide, the optimum cost function value. Then the optimum tap gain is derived from this previous expression, that is in the normal equation. From this equation, if we bring Rnn to the right hand side, then this tap gain Wn cap is equal to Rnn inverse into Pn. That is the equation which is given in the bottom of the slide. So Wn cap is equal to Rnn inverse into Pn. So here we take the inverse of the autocorrelation matrix Rnn, so it requires n cube number of arithmetic operations. This LMS algorithm is very simplest algorithm. It requires only 2n plus 1 operations per iteration. If n denotes the sequence of iteration, then the tap gain or the weight vector is updated by using this equation. The first equation is the output expression of the adaptive equalizer dk cap, which is the product of the weight vector and the input vector. Then the second equation is the prediction error, which is the difference between this desired output and the output of the equalizer. Then the third equation is the updated equation of the weight vector, which is given by Wn of n plus 1, that is updated value is equal to Wn of n, which is the current value, minus alpha into the error ek into the input value yn of n, where alpha is the step size, which is used to control the convergence rate and the stability of the algorithm. Then the advantages of this LMS algorithm. This LMS algorithm maximizes the signal to distortion ratio with less number of equalizer coefficients. If the input signal has time dispersion characteristic that is greater than the propagation delay through the equalizer, then the equalizer cannot reduce the distortion. One more advantage is that it has low computational complexity. Then in the disadvantages, the convergence rate is slow because it contains only one parameter, step size alpha. The another disadvantage is that the poor tracking. The step size alpha depends on the parameter lambda I, which is the eigenvalue of the covariance matrix RNN. The eigenvalues of the covariance matrix RNN is expressed in terms of the input vector YN. The step size depends on lambda I, which is expressed by the input vector. So the step size can be controlled by changing the input vector YN to avoid the instability of the equalizer.